Hi, good day. Yeah, I'm talking to you. Hello, how are you doing today? Welcome to my platform. Actually, this platform is meant for training, and I trust that with this platform, if you pay good attention to this platform, you don't need to go anywhere else for training. You can become an expert. You can start working on your own and earning your own money. All you need to do is put what you see me doing here to practice. It's very important. Don't just watch the video. Watch the video and practice it. I will be dropping my number, my WhatsApp number under it so that you can send me your work. It's very important to me. Please, I will correct it if there is need for it. Okay, so the video is about how I made the fan you saw, the gele, you just see that I lose now, how I made it. So I'm just going to go into details how I make it. Why I make my gele that way is because it helps me to manage the material. One way people can make auto gele is to first of all tie it like you are tying it on a client. So by the time you are done tying and beautifying it, then you can cut it out. But why, if you are using that method, it requires a lot of material. So in order for you to be able to manage your material, this is what I advise that you do. So after joining your Asoki together and then getting the wideness you need, the next thing I will do is to first of all base a dummy head with a pinnable material, a material that I can pin, not something that is too strong. So I prefer using suede or using ankara to base the head first. So that will act as a base that I can attach this Asoki to. So the next thing you see me doing is folding this Asoki, just like the way you pleat it, where you are tying it on a client's head. So I will fold it, and when I get to the height I believe it's okay for me, then I will use needle and thread and then secure that position. I'll use needle and thread and then secure it. So when I secure it with needle, and the reason I'm doing this is so that I will keep it in place. You know, I am not tying it to anywhere. I'm not tying it like I'm tying a client's head. So I need somewhere that will support it. Like somebody, when I tack it to the head of the dummy, it will look as if somebody is holding it for me. You understand? So, and it will help me to be able to tie this gele now without the help of anybody. You know, sometimes you can use anybody that is willing to sit down for you to prepare your auto gele, especially when you don't have the dummy head. But please, I advise that if you are already into this business, get a dummy head because it's part of the requirement you need to do this business. So now, after I tack it to the head of the dummy, and remember what I put under, I make sure that the base is very tight so it will avoid the losing and falling off. Yes, so the next thing you see me doing is guiding the pleat I have before with my fingers. Guide it properly with my fingers. So after doing that, I will move it downward because I want the pleat to be everywhere. So that's the reason I'm moving it down, shifting it. And as I keep tying, I might still continue to shift so that I will just make sure that I get the fan all round to the point I want it. But the style I am making with this is not a full fan. It is half fan. I'm stopping at the middle or a little bit to the side. I'm stopping a little bit to the side. So that's why you see where I am guiding it. It's not a full fan. So every pleat that you make, every pleat you make, is very important that you arrange it. It is through the arrangement that you see the fan, because we call this style of a tie, fan a tie. That is through the arrangement, proper arrangement, that you will now see the fan standing. So after I secure the both parts, because I am already trying to create the fan. Now, this is very important. In trying to create the fan, it is important you slant the material, like you see me, like what I did now. With this next fold I took, you will see that the ending part of this hair tie and the part where I am holding now is no longer the same. You will see that the lower part, the material is now shorter compared to where my hand is. That's what I mean by slanting it. So when you slant it, it gives it the base for it to quickly start to stand. You understand? It helps it to stand fast. So slanting it is the key. If you do not slant it in time, you will not get the fan coming out in time. So the quicker you slant the hair tie, the better for whatever you are doing. The quicker you slant it, the better. So because I have slanted, you see that the edges are no longer, it's already getting it's stepping out already, it's coming out. So for every pleat I make, to stand the fan, maybe after one or two pleats, I will need to shift my hand, that is move forward. And the only way I can move forward is to use my second hand to arrange the part that is rough there, and then get it together and then move, because you have to keep moving. You understand? As you move, you keep arranging the edges together to make sure that they are on top of each other. If they are not on top of each other, this fan will not stand. The line you are seeing that I'm creating now, that is making it to stand and that is sustaining it there, will not be there. So please, it is very important that you guide it. You guide it. It's very, very important. And as you are guiding it, you make sure that as you want to move, you have to place your hand and guide the part that you already created while you are using your next hand to arrange it properly. Okay, it's like my body is covering the camera. So let me adjust it and then bring it closer to the camera for you to see. I'm sorry for that, for the fact that my body covered the camera. So let me move it closer. Okay. So this is what I'm doing. Just folding it, making sure that whatever I am folding now will not be bigger than the previous ones that I have folded, and it will not be smaller than it, because once it is bigger than it or smaller than it, this arrangement, the fan arrangement you have made now, will begin to fall, and you will not want that. The only thing that will make it not to fall is to make sure that you try as much as possible to for your folding to be even, that is equal. It might not really be completely equal, but what will make your work outstanding is seeing to it that it is almost equal. When it is almost equal, every movement you make will stand. It will stand. Every slant that you take will stand. But when it is not equal, you are folding some big and some small, the fan will begin to fall. Okay, so like I said before, I am not preparing a full fan. It's not a full fan. I said I'm stopping at the side. That's just the style that I am making. So it's not a full fan. Yes. So right now that I am done pleating it, the next thing I will do is, you see that part that I'm holding with my hand? I will not let it go. I will not leave it at all. Because the moment you release this part that you are holding with your hand, all what you have been sweating and stressing yourself for since will just fall, and you will just lose the shape again. You have to start all over again. So I will hold it tight, get needle and thread, and then make sure I tack it. Tack it together. So after tacking it together, I don't have any problem anymore. It is already in place. So I made a video on the base before. So the video of the base is on my channel. So right now I want to fix what I have made to the base. I want to fix it to the base, and this is just what I will do to fix it to the base. So I will just determine how far I want the opening to go. That is the beginning. How wide I want it to fall on my neck, you understand? So that is how far you will go. You understand me now? So in placing it there, you just use your needle and thread and then tack it together. So after tacking it there, I just want to make a little tutorial on the handle, on how you fix the handle. Now, for the handle, you know that after I tack that part, you have some part that is remaining. So you just have to cut it off. Cut it off to the lowest. To the lowest, because if you don't cut it to the lowest, when you want to tie it, you will find out that the handle is not moving. With the excess of whatever you are leaving will not allow the handle to move when you want to tie it. So it is very important that you cut it as low as possible, but not too low, but at least it should be reasonably low, you understand? And then when you are attaching the handle, you see what I did to the gele now. You don't just attach and allow it to fall. Make sure it stands back. So when you are attaching it, don't just press it and begin to sew. No, make sure that this part that is standing remains standing before you use your needle and thread. Machine don't usually sew this part because it's too thick. Except you really have a very big machine. My own machine don't use to sew it. So what I do is for me to just use needle and thread, and then I will sew it neatly. Make sure that my work is neat using needle and thread. And it's very important what I want to explain now. You see the part that I'm folding there now, you will sew that part first. Don't stop at that. Then the part where you cut and it end, that part I am holding now, you will sew it again. So to attach the handle, you are sewing two parts for both sides. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial. That will be all for today. Please, if you have any question, just drop it on my comment section. I will reply you. You are very important to me. I will reply you. So just drop your comment. I will reply. I promise. If I don't reply immediately, before 2-3 days, I will. All right. Thank you for watching. Bye.